Well, thank you so much for that presentation. Your Excellencies, thank you for inviting me to speak at this year's Raisina Dialogue. I feel very privileged to be the first Danish Foreign Minister to do so. So, ladies and gentlemen, this conference is committed to addressing the most challenging issues facing our global community. Therefore, my speech today will focus on the need for climate action. Because climate change is a matter of global security and stability. I want to talk to you about climate change as a serious threat to global security and stability. What the new Danish government is doing to fight climate change, how Denmark and India are working together, how we can expand this partnership even further, and how all of us can provide global leadership on this vital issue. But first, I want to paint a mental image for you. So please, imagine this. A mouse and an elephant is walking together through the forest. Heavy footprints hit the ground with a resounding thump. The mouse looks up at the elephant and says, "Wow, can you hear how loud it rumbles when we walk?" I'll return to that image later. However, these days across the globe, the forests really are rumbling, but for a very different reason. They're rumbling with the sound of wildfires. The Amazon, Africa, Australia, all have seen devastating wildfires, and all in the space of just around half a year. Climate change is visible, changing the ground beneath our feet, endangering wildlife, flora, biodiversity, people's lives, homes, and basic living conditions. Already, people are driven from their lands, perhaps because the land is now barren. Because of rising temperatures and the lack of rain, or the opposite, flooding and extreme storms, climate change has many faces. It is happening right now. Food insecurity and serious health implications are the visible symptoms in many regions. This again leads to displacement, migration, and conflict, affecting the most vulnerable population the most. Ultimately, climate change can destabilize entire countries and regions, with serious implications for our collective and individual security. So what does this mean in practice? It means that global climate policy is now also security policy, and vice versa. In much the same way as energy policy is, dependence on imported fossil fuels is a well-known security risk for any nation. Going green, going renewable, means both a better future for our planet, for our children, and offers to any nation the promise of self-reliance. Failure to act on climate change, however, will eventually lead to confrontation. That is why climate is a key concern for me as a foreign minister. The good news is that many of the solutions are right in front of us, but the answer is not to be found in the classical security toolbox. The answer is green, and the technology is here, and it requires both national and international action. Denmark will do its part. We have a responsibility to act. We owe that to our children. We must not let the next generation inherit the problems of ours. Ladies and gentlemen, Denmark is an old nation full of new ideas. We may not be the biggest country in the world, but we have big ambitions. And we have decided to become a global green superpower. We hope to share that title with India. My government is delivering concrete action. We have set a very ambitious target: climate neutrality and net zero emissions by 2050 at the latest. Only last month, a wide political majority agreed on a new Danish climate bill. It includes a legally binding target of reducing greenhouse gas emissions by 70% by 2030. It is one of the world's most ambitious climate bills, and it requires a new policy perspective. Instead of asking what is possible, we started by asking what is necessary. This is the level of ambition needed if we are to meet our global climate goals. Of course, Denmark's green transition did not start last year. The ambitious climate policy built on decades of green political consensus. Denmark used to be dependent on fossil fuels, but after the oil crisis in the 1970s, it was clear that we needed to change. Part of the response was to fund research into new alternative energy, wind, combined heat and power, energy efficiency. Today, Denmark has the world's highest share of renewable energy. Wind and solar provided over 50% of electricity consumption in 2019. In 2028, 100% of electricity will come from renewable energy. Since 1990, Denmark's GDP has grown by 55%, while both energy consumption and CO2 emissions have decreased at the same time. This is the Green Danish model, and it has strengthened both our energy security and our economy and our competitiveness. Yesterday, the report Getting to the Green Frontier was launched here at the Raisina Dialogue. The report indicates that India could well benefit from the same approach. The Danish case shows that it's possible to decouple economic growth and energy consumption, and it has boosted our green tech industry. Danish company has become global market leaders in green sectors, renewable energy, energy efficiency, water, and environment. More than 80% of the world's offshore wind turbines are either produced in Denmark or contain Danish components. At a global scale, New Climate Economy estimate that the global economic benefit of the green transition to be $26 trillion from 2018 to 2030. The need for green solutions and the market potential keep growing, creating both business and job opportunities. Competitiveness and sustainability can go hand in hand. But we also have to ensure social mobility. That is a clear political priority to me and the Danish government. Policies must also deliver a just transition for the people whose jobs and livelihoods are at risk. We must ensure that climate action promotes equality, that we leave no one behind, neither at national nor at global level. Therefore, Denmark has made just green transition a key priority for Danish development cooperation. Denmark will strengthen support to other countries raising their climate ambitions and spur concrete action. Everyone has to benefit from the green transition. Sustainability is a social issue, an economic issue, and a democratic issue. If we fail here, protest, civil unrest, and instability will be the cost. If we succeed, prosperity, social mobility, and cohesion will be the reward. Now, let me turn to our global responsibility. International collaboration is of essence. No country can deal with climate change alone. So, what are countries like Denmark and India doing to facilitate global climate action? Requested by the Secretary General, Denmark took leadership on energy transition for the Climate Action Summit. Together with Ethiopia, sustainable energy and SDG 7 is critical to combat climate change. Energy accounts for 80% of the global emissions, 80%. Combining renewable energy, energy efficiency, electrification can ensure 90% of the emission reductions needed by 2050 and create access to sustainability and sustainable energy for all. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, we need to focus our political energy on energy. And India together with Sweden, has taken the lead on industry transition for the UN Climate Action Summit, focusing on sectors that are hard to decarbonize, heavy industry and heavy duty transports. Denmark has joined the leadership group set up by India and Sweden. We are looking forward to share insights from Danish government's climate partnership with the private sector on decarbonization of sectors. This leads me to another way of boosting climate action, public-private partnerships. The private sector can contribute to climate action with financial capital, innovative ideas, and technology solutions. Denmark is a part of the initiative Partnering for Green Growth and the Global Goals, P4G. Promoting innovative public-private solutions for green growth and climate action. Denmark and India are frontrunners in realizing the potential of public-private partnership as a driver for green innovation. Let's continue to do so. Furthermore, we can boost global climate action by strengthening bilateral cooperation and mutual exchange of knowledge. We welcome India's continued political leadership on green energy. And I look forward to our future collaboration to accelerate the global green transition. India has engaged ambitiously under the Paris Agreement. This shows both national and global leadership to fight climate change. The national push of renewable energy has already generated impressive results and making India an important market and industry hub. India's target of reaching 175 gigawatts of renewable energy capacity in 2022 is ambitious. And last year at the climate summit in New York, Honorable Prime Minister Modi stated a target of reaching 450 gigawatts of renewable energy. Showing India will continue to take global leadership on climate change. India has also supported the establishment of the International Solar Alliance and is driving its impressive developments. Denmark is currently also considering, of course, joining this important initiative. India and Denmark share ambitions on promoting renewable energy implementation. We can become partners in leading a green energy movement in light with the global target for mitigating climate change. India has great potential to play an important role in future energy transition. Therefore, in December 2019, Denmark supported India in becoming a strategic partner in the International Energy Agency. We believe it's time for all countries to join forces. We have to use and make use of our differences in order to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. Considering its scale, India has to be part of the equation. India and Denmark has already strengthened our bilateral relationship considerably in recent years. Spearheading this development has been the close cooperation on sector level. The government of India and the government of Denmark are now working closely in key sectors: renewable energy, smart cities, water and wastewater, intellectual property rights, as well as science and innovation. Let me give a good example. In the 1990s, Denmark assisted with knowledge sharing and financing to set up the first wind testing facilities in southern India. Today, India has the fourth largest wind power capacity in the world. Many Danish companies have been part of this journey by entering the market, establishing manufacturing and research and development facilities. Today, the Danish and Indian governments have a strategic sector cooperation focused on supporting the ambitious Indian target for offshore wind in India. Under a new government-to-government program, the India and Denmark Energy Partnership and Indo-Danish Center of Excellence for Offshore Wind and Integrated Renewable Power will be established. It will serve as a hub for the development of this new promising sector in India. On solar energy, Denmark is learning from India. The scale and pace of India's development will provide important learning regarding solar, hybrid power plants, energy storage, and mobility. Ladies and gentlemen, our response to climate change is the challenge of our time. We cannot negotiate with nature. And to be brutally honest, sometimes we cannot even negotiate amongst ourselves, the countries of the world. The recent climate conference in Madrid was a disappointment. World leaders must now show political leadership and raise ambitions. We have to do better, and we have to act decisively. It is time for us who are willing to act to join forces before it's too late. The next climate conference in Glasgow, COP26, will be decisive. Denmark is ready to lead the way along with other green global superpowers. Denmark and India have a unique position to elevate global climate ambitions and facilitate global action. As green strategic partnership and global climate leaders, we have an opportunity to show the world that green transition is possible and that we can provide change. We need not only to deliver climate action, we must deliver climate action that leaves no one behind and prevent future conflict due to lack of natural resources. This is not an easy task, but it's our obligation. Prime Minister Modi's vision is a new India. Ladies and gentlemen, let us together expand that vision to a new world and make our common future green. Global stability and security depend on us. In closing, I would like to return to the story of the mouse and the elephant. I'm confident that the image of the mouse and the elephant is not lost on our esteemed audience. In this global fight against climate change, Denmark may be small in stature. But as Honorable Prime Minister Modi has said, Denmark has the skill, India has the scale. And I would add that India certainly also has the skills. So let's walk together. Let's forge new sustainable paths. Let's rumble the forest with large green footprints together. Thank you so much.